Hi! In this video, I want to discuss the impact of earnings growth on value. While it is commonly believed that higher growth necessarily leads to higher value, we will see that it's not true. To illustrate, let's look at this example. We have two firms with the same after-tax EBIT and the same growth on that earnings. The companies, however, are different in their investment rates and their return on capital. While company A invests 50% of its after-tax EBIT in its business and has a return on capital of 10%, company B reinvests only 25% of its earnings, which is half as much as company A, but has a return on investments twice as much as company A, which is 20%. As you can remember, free cash flow to the firm could be written as after-tax EBIT minus required investments including CapEx and working capital. With this, you can easily compute the free cash flow to the firm in this example. For instance, in year one, after-tax EBIT for both companies are 100, but reinvestments in company A is 50 versus 25 in company B. You can clearly see that company B will end up with higher free cash flows due to lower investment needs to sustain the same growth rate. Before going to formally show you how growth and value are related, let's look at different methods that could be useful when you need to estimate future growth rates in your DCF. Overall, there are three different pieces of information that collectively could help you to estimate a reasonable growth rate for your company. The first one is to look at the past and compute historical growth rates. You can also check analyst forecasts of future growth rate, which is nice since they are forward-looking. The drawback is that there might be huge disagreements between analysts in forecasting growth rates, in particular for younger and less mature companies. Also, pay attention to what the analysts are forecasting. You need EBIT growth for your DCF valuation, while analysts typically forecast earnings per share growth, which may be quite different. The third approach to have an estimated future growth rate is to look at fundamentals. Growth happens either because of more investments or because of higher return on those investments. The advantage of this fundamental approach is that the growth rate here will no longer be an exogenous variable that affects value, but instead the growth rate here is an endogenous variable that is determined by how the firm operates. Again, based on this approach, if you want to have a higher growth, you either need to invest more or invest in higher quality projects with higher return on capital. So, if we go back to the earlier example, you see that company A with a return on capital that is half of the one of B can have the same growth rate as company B if it invests twice as much as what company B invests. With similar logic, you can see that company A can even have a higher growth rate than company B if it invests more than 50% of its earnings. This is telling you that having a higher growth per se cannot be value increasing since a company can always reach to higher growth by investing more. To show this a bit more formally, let's assume a simple cash flow with constant growth rate G. The present value of this stream can be written as the cash flow in year one divided to cost of capital minus the growth rate, which is G. From this formula, we can see that as free cash flow goes up, the value goes up. If the cost of capital or WACC goes up, the value goes down. But what about increasing the growth rate? It seems that if the growth rate goes up, the value also goes up. But what you will soon see is that this is because we are treating growth as a completely exogenous variable. In other words, to have a higher growth, the firm may need to reinvest more or change its return on capital, all of which will be affecting the free cash flow, the numerator in this equation. So let's try to expand this formula. As shown before, we can write free cash flow as EBIT times 1 minus tax rate times 1 minus investment rate. In addition, we can use the fundamental growth formula to replace investment rates with growth divided to return on invested capital. This leads us to this final equation where you can see that G, or the growth, not only shows up in the denominator but also in the numerator. Here you can clearly see what drives value. The higher the current earnings, the higher the value. The higher the return on capital, the higher the value. The higher the tax rate, the lower the value. The higher the cost of capital, the lower the value. But how does value changes if growth or G goes up? The answer is not clear. It depends on the signs of the term return on capital minus WACC. If the return on capital is higher than the cost of capital, higher growth creates value. If return on capital is equal to the cost of capital, the firm creates no value through growth. And finally, and importantly, if the return on capital is lower than the cost of capital, the firm destroys value by trying to grow faster. Thank you for watching.